Virtually every police service in the Western world is grappling with the issue of bias. Who they stop and question, who they decide to charge, and when they use force. Here in Aotearoa, New Zealand, it's been proven that Māori and Pacifica are unfairly targeted by police. A report last month from the Independent Police Conduct Authority and the Office of the Privacy Commissioner found the practice of collecting the photos and fingerprints of young Māori people to be illegal. A recent example of many. However, our police force has at least recognised there's a question to be answered, so last year they appointed an independent panel to get to the bottom of it. For more, I'm joined by chair of that independent panel, Sir Kim Workman, to update us on how that work is progressing. Morena, Kim, thank you so much for being with us this morning. Really appreciate you and being here and appreciate the work that you're doing on this as well. It's such important work, and I wondered whether we could start by getting the state of play as you see it in terms of the bias that operates in our police service.
Certainly. You know, we formed this panel back in March of last year. We've been working closely with the police and, in fact, have been having discussions between the independent panel and frontline police officers, and working with them to identify what potentially could be areas of bias.
And how's that work going? How are those conversations going, Kim?
They've been really successful, because once the police understood that we're not talking about personal bias or unconscious bias, we're talking about systemic bias. And that's really about the procedures, the policies, the legislation that often contribute to bias, overall. And they're coming up with examples themselves of areas that they think there might be bias.
Well, I look at where that bias might lead us. You know, there's some of the statistics, Kim. Māori make up 50% of our prison population, despite only accounting for 15% of the general population. Right now, one in every 142 Māori New Zealanders is in prison. Māori are prosecuted and convicted at a higher rate than anyone else. So this permeates everything.
Yes, it does. And it's a complex issue. That involves not only the police, but corrections, the judiciary. In fact, it also includes the education system and the health system. So what the police end up with often is dealing with people who have been neglected by the Crown in the past, and are dealing with that end of it. But on top of that, we have issues around, you know, for example, how do the police go about stopping people and asking them questions? What do they do when they're required to use force? Are there any opportunities to de-escalate the situation? And when they make decisions to prosecute people, how fair are the processes around that? So these are the sorts of questions that the research teams we have just announced have been established to work with both the police and the communities to try to get to the bottom of that and to provide some, a really close look at what's going on and how it might be dealt with.
So you've just announced these research teams, Kim. What is the scope of their work? What is it that they'll be doing?
Well, they'll be doing, first of all, data analysis around, because we can't do this work unless we have evidence. And so they'll be doing a data analysis of all the police data and what that means. They'll be talking with communities across the country, with Māori, Pacifica communities, with the Rainbow communities, with other disabled communities, to get to to understand the level of bias within the system.
I mean, something clearly needs to be done about this, Kim, but is this in and of itself a good thing that you're even being commissioned in the first place to actually do this work?
Well, I think it's different, because in the past, government agencies have put out reports which identify the sort of statistics that you just quoted. And then the report sits there and nobody does anything about it. And this is a very different, because the panel, the independent panel, was given a mandate to challenge the any research that was done, to question the police, to have a co-equal relationship with the police. So it's, in a way, it's a co-leadership model. And 4 months into the work that we were doing, the police asked us if we would manage the research itself, which is quite an accolade. And I think that happened because of the quality of the people. You know, when you've got people like Professor Paul Spoonley, Lady Trinity Moxon, Professor Kylie Quince, community leaders who know what they're talking about and are not going to be put off easily, then you've got confidence in them to do the job.
I mean, those people aren't going to be put off by this, but it can be quite confronting for people if they're, you know, confronted with, to be told that there might be racism in the things that they're doing, or there might be bias in the way that they handle things. Are you expecting pushback at all from police itself?
Well, we've talked that through with the police, and what we've said and what we've decided to look for is, how do we improve police performance? How do we get fair and equitable policing in New Zealand? And the police are really comfortable with that. We're not accusing them of being racist. What we're saying is, if there is bias, can we find out where it's happening, why it's happening, and what we need to do to put it right? And so that's the approach that's been acceptable to them.
There has been some criticism, Kim. I was reading some comments from People Against Prisons Aotearoa, for example, who said, look, we know bias exists. We don't need a report to tell us that this happens in our society. So how do we make this mean something, Kim?
I think we make it mean something by actually producing the evidence. Nobody has done the research to establish exactly why that that difference exists, and this research will dig deeper than has ever happened before to establish, you know, why is it that you know, Maori are being refused bail, for example, twice more frequently than non-Maori, and once you find that out, you can start to address the issues.
Yeah, so that's a long-term
thing,
isn't it, Kim?
We're talking about evidence-based research, really.
Yeah. That's a long-term thing, though, isn't it, Kim, to change those behaviours?
Yes, and it's going to take us a couple of years to finish the research. And what we hope is that we can leave a legacy with the police, so that they can continue to improve the way they deliver policing for years to come.
Kim, thank you so much for being with us this morning and for the work that you're doing. This is a long-term project, but something that needs to be addressed. So we really appreciate your time this morning. Tā Kim Workman, a criminal justice advocate working on this incredible research. Thank you so much.
Kia ora.